Hello everyone, I hope you have enjoyed your Ugadi festival. So let us go for another topic. This is alternate method to calculate rise time, fall time and time delay. So in this video I am going to teach you what is the alternate method to calculate the rise time, fall time and the delay time. So first let us consider rise time. I had already explained to you what rise time is. The definition of rise time is the time taken for the output signal to rise from 0.1 to 0.9 VDD, or in other words, the change in the output voltage from 10% to 90% of the maximum output voltage is done in this particular interval, that is the rise time. So once again consider the inverter, which consists of PMOS and NMOS transistors. When Vin is equal to 0, PMOS will be on and NMOS will be off. And Vin is equal to 1, PMOS is off and NMOS is on. So for calculating the rise time, we consider Vin is equal to 0 so that the PMOS transistor is on and NMOS transistor is off. So PMOS transistor is replaced by its equivalent resistance RP, which is the resistance of the pull-up transistor. And because the NMOS transistor is off, charging of the load capacitance takes place through RP. So the charging current is given by I is equal to VDD minus Vout by RP. So here in this diagram, charging current is equal to difference in the voltages divided by the resistance. So I is equal to VDD minus Vout by RP. And because the same current is flowing through the capacitor and it is charging the capacitor, we can write the current equal to CL dV out by DT. That is CL into differentiation of the voltage across the capacitor with respect to the time. So the charging current is given by VDD minus Vout by RP, which will be equal to CL dV out by DT. Now from this, we can write dV out by DT plus Vout by RPCL is equal to VDD by RPCL. I have just rearranged the terms of the equation of the current. Now for simplicity's sake, RP into CL is denoted by tau P. So dV out by DT plus V out by tau P equal to VDD by tau P. Now this is a differential equation and the solution to the differential equation is given by V out of T equal to VDD into 1 minus e to the power of minus T by tau P. So that we need to find out T, that is why we'll rearrange the terms. V out by VDD is equal to 1 minus e to the power of minus T by tau P. Then e to the power of minus T by tau P will bring to one side and this term to the other side. So that e to the power of minus T by tau P is equal to 1 minus V out by VDD. Or taking the LCM, it is VDD minus V out by VDD. We take the reciprocal because I want to make e to the power of minus t by tau p as e to the power of plus t by tau p. So e to the power of plus t by tau p is equal to VDD by VDD minus V out. Or if we take natural logarithm on both the sides, I would get t by tau p is equal to natural logarithm of VDD by VDD minus V out of t. Or in other words, t equal to tau p natural logarithm of VDD by VDD minus V out of T. So this is the expression in which I can substitute the values of time and the value of the output voltage at that particular time. So this is the equation which satisfies the condition that PMOS is on and charging takes place, or in other words, the output voltage is rising, or the transition of the output voltage is from 0 to 5 volts. So this equation can be used to calculate the rise time, so that we can take the time at which the output voltage is 0.1 VDD or 10% of the maximum value of the output voltage. Similarly, we can take the time at which the output voltage is 0.9 VDD or 90% of the maximum value of the output voltage, and the difference would give us the rise time. So from this particular waveform, what we can see is that the output voltage, when it is rising from 0 volts to 5 volts, it will not rise abruptly, but there is a slow transition. Now, the time taken for the output voltage to change from 10% to 90% of the maximum output voltage is rise time. So let us take time t1 as the time at which the output reaches 0.1 VDD and time t2 at which the output reaches 0.9 VDD. So t2 minus t1 will give us the rise time, and the voltage at t2 is 0.9 VDD. Voltage at t1 is 0.1 VDD, which we are going to substitute in the expression of t which we had got just now. So rise time is equal to t2 minus t1, and the rise time is given by t2 minus t1. So in place of t2, I have substituted tau p, natural logarithm of VDD by VDD minus, in place of V out, I have substituted 0.9 VDD, because at T2, the output voltage is 0.9 VDD. Similarly, minus T1. So minus, in place of T1, it is tau P, natural logarithm of VDD by VDD minus 0.1 VDD, because at T1, the output voltage is 0.1 VDD. So we know that log A minus log B can be written as log A by B. So the above expression can now be simplified to tau p into natural logarithm of VDD minus 0.1 VDD by VDD minus 0.9 VDD, which will be tau p natural logarithm of 9. And natural logarithm of 9 is 2.2, and tau p I have replaced here with Rp into Cl. Resistance of a PMOS transistor is given by 1 by beta into VDD minus magnitude of VTP. Now, let us assume that VTP, that is the threshold voltage of the PMOS transistor, is minus 0.2 VDD. Now, before that, I am going to substitute this RP in the expression which we got for the rise time. So we will get tau r is equal to 2.2 into Cl into Rp. So in place of Rp, I am writing 1 by beta p into VDD minus VTP. Now in place of magnitude of VTP, we will substitute 0.2 VDD. So that tau r equal to 2.2 Cl by beta p into VDD minus 0.2 VDD will be 0.8 VDD, and this, when we calculate 2.2 by 0.8, it is 2.75, and this can be approximated as 3 Cl by beta p VDD. The same expression we had got when we did calculate the rise time using another method in the previous video. Now let us see the method which is used to calculate the fault time. Now here, once again, for calculating the fault time, we assume Vin is equal to 5 volts or VDD, so that PMOS is off and NMOS is on, and PMOS, it is replaced with its resistance RN. Now the capacitor is discharging through RN to ground, so that the current I can be given by V out minus 0 by Rn, where Rn is the resistance of the pull down transistor, that is the NMOS transistor. So I is equal to V out minus 0 by Rn, that is the voltage difference divided by the resistance. And because it is discharging current, so In terms of CL, the current can also be given as minus CL dV out by dt. Minus because it is discharging current. So now we bring this to the other side and write the expression as dV out by dt plus V out by RNCL equal to 0. And the expression, this particular expression which we got is differential equation, and the solution of the differential equation would be V out is equal to VDD e to the power of minus t by RN into CL, or RN into CL for simplicity we write it as tau n. Now to calculate t, we'll get VDD by V out is equal to e to the power of t by tau n, or t is equal to tau n natural logarithm of VDD by V out. Now using this expression we can calculate the fall time, because fall time is the time taken for the output to fall from 90% to 10% of its maximum value. So let us say that at time t3 the output voltage is 90% of the maximum value, or 0.9 VDD, and at t4 the output voltage is 0.1 VDD or 10% of the maximum value, so that t4 minus t3 will give us the fall time. So here at t3 the output voltage is 0.9 VDD, and at t4 the output voltage is 0.1 VDD. So when we substitute in place of t4, we will substitute tau n into natural logarithm of VDD by 0.1 VDD, minus in place of t3 it is tau n into natural logarithm of VDD by 0.9 VDD. Or once again, when we simplify this expression, we'll get tau n natural logarithm of 9, which is 2.2 tau n, and tau n is replaced with RN into CL, and RN is replaced with the expression for resistance of the NMOS transistor, which is 1 by beta n into VDD minus VTN. Now let us assume VTN is equal to 0.2 VDD, then tau f, that is the fall time, is given by 2.2 CL by beta n into VDD minus 0.2 VDD, that is 0.8 VDD, which will be 2.75 CL by beta n VDD, or it can be approximated to be 3 CL by beta n into VDD. So this is the same expression which we got for the fall time using different method in the previous video. Now tau r is equal to 2.2 CL by beta p into 0.8 VDD, or 3 CL by beta p into VDD, and tau f is equal to 2.2 CL by beta n into 0.8 VDD, or 3 CL by beta n into VDD. These are the expressions which we have got for tau r and tau f. In these expressions, the value of beta p is the device transconductance, as I had explained you in the previous video. It is equal to mu p cox wp by lp, where wp and lp are the width and length of the channel in the PMOS transistor. Similarly, beta n is the transconductance, that is the device transconductance of NMOS transistor. It is given by mu n cox wn by ln, and we know that mu n is equal to 2.5 mu p. Now if wp equal to wn and lp will anyway be equal to ln, because we are using a particular technology, L will remain constant, then in that particular case beta n by beta p equal to 2.5. and if I take this, that is beta n is equal to 2.5 beta p, and substitute in the expression of tau r and tau f, we will come to know that tau r is equal to 2.5 tau f. Similarly, as explained in the previous video, if tau r need to be equal to tau f, then wp will be equal to 2.5 wn. That means if we want symmetric waveform at the output, then we have to increase the width of the PMOS transistor, and that should be equal to 2.5 into WN. Thus, it is seen that tau R and tau F are proportional to 1 by VDD and directly proportional to CL. And tau R is equal to 2.5 tau F if N and P transistors are of equal geometry. Similarly, WP will be equal to 2.5 WN for symmetric operation, or if tau R is equal to tau F. Delay time TD. Delay time TD, as I explained you in the previous video, it is given by the time difference between 50% of the input transition and 50% of the output transition. And I had explained you that 50% of the input transition occurs at this particular point and 50% of the output transition occurs at this point, so that this time difference is given by the delay time. Similarly, when the input is changing from 5 volts to 0 volts, output is changing from 0 to 5 volts. So once again, 50% of the transition of the input is at this point and 50% of the output is at this point. So the time difference is denoted by TD2. So the total delay time is given by TD1 plus TD2 by 2. And we assumed that TD1 is equal to rise time by 2 and TD2 is fall time by 2, so that TD can be given as tau R plus tau F by 4. Instead of we assuming that TD1 and TD2 are equal to tau R by 2 and tau F by 2, we can actually calculate the value of the delay time using the expressions which we have just calculated. So we can get TD1 by substituting TD1 in place of T in the expression T equal to tau N natural logarithm of VDD by Vout of T. So TD1 will be equal to tau N natural logarithm of VDD by V out of T will be 0.5 VDD, that is 50% of the maximum value. So that we'll get tau N natural logarithm of 2 or 0.693 tau N, and tau N is equal to Rn into Cl. Similarly, TD2 can be obtained by substituting in place of T TD2 and T equal to tau P natural logarithm of VDD by VDD minus V out of T, and in place of V out of T we have to substitute 0.5 VDD. So TD2 equal to tau P natural logarithm of VDD by VDD minus 0.5 VDD, or tau P into natural logarithm of 2, which once again will be 0.693 tau P or 0.693 RP into CL. Now we know that the delay time is given by the average of TD1 and TD2. So when we substitute, we'll get approximately 0.35 tau N plus tau P. Now, if Vin is symmetric square wave, that is, it has a 50% duty cycle, then maximum signal frequency can be given by 1 by tau R plus tau F. Maximum signal frequency is the largest frequency that can be applied to the gate and still allow the output to settle to a definable state. I repeat, maximum signal frequency is the largest frequency that can be applied to the gate and allow the output to settle to a definable state. But if the signal frequency is greater than the maximum frequency, then the output will not have sufficient time to stabilize to the constant value. So we have to see it to it that the signal which we are going to apply, its frequency should be less than or equal to the fmax value. So I hope you have understood the contents of this video. Thank you and have a good day.